A host world feed production is a single production that is used to facilitate all of the productions all around the world. And it allows them to either use that production directly to their air or to supplement that production, their own graphics, their own music, their own announcers.
March 15th, we started weekly calls with all of our partners, particularly on the broadcast side. 35 rights holders, national and regional. We started to figure out and put a landscape plan in for a world feed that would be able to satisfy their needs.
So when this came to fruition, the NHL assigned NBC to produce the World Feed Hub in Toronto, and Rogers Sportsnet is producing the World Feed Hub in Edmonton.
Before you can even really talk about producing these games, you know, in the world we're living in with COVID-19, at first you need to make sure it's safe and abide by all the health and safety protocols. So the first step was figuring out how do you produce shows and how do you, you know, make it safe for players and all the staff working and make sure everyone's socially distanced.
Here in Edmonton, like in Toronto, we get tested every morning. I am thrilled the way they're handling things. I feel very safe here. I don't feel like anybody is in. You can't come in here if you're not in the bubble. I think all of us feel very safe.
Up here in the Eastern Conference playoff bubble, we have up to 60 production and engineering folks, a little more than half traveled, and we also are utilizing a lot of talented Canadian folks that live here in Toronto or close by.
This crew work every single day. So on a three-game day, they do three games. And tomorrow, if it's a three-game day, they do three games that day as well. The dedication level is over the moon.
So on the production side, we have two teams. They will not intermingle. They won't cross-contaminate, so to speak. Where normally we have 20 people in our mobile unit, for this, we have 9 or 10.
Usually when you're in a truck at home, there's 5 tape operators, 3 in the front, 2 in the back. Here, there's 2 in one truck, 3 in another truck, and they've spaced everybody out, except in the front where we have producer, director, and technical director who switches all the cameras and all the tape machines.
Safety is a prime concern here. In our workspace in the truck, for example, we have plexiglass partitions between producers, directors, technical directors. We're wearing masks for the duration of the telecasts.
You can't run the risk. If somebody were to become ill, God forbid, and therefore becomes an issue for those that were around them, all of a sudden we can't do the production, that's going to be a real problem. How are you going to lay out the facilities within that truck, the personnel, and then what do you do and how do you implement those that you have to remove from that truck? So then you have to, what we call outboard, and put those people in different areas.
We have about 2/3 of the people that normally work in our production truck outboarded in different areas in the arena. So it's definitely unique for us and it's a different challenge.
The World Feed is to cover what just happened. You have one feed coming out of the building. That's it. You are the only show of record here. If you miss something, no one will see it. There's no fans to see it and there's no other networks to cover it. There's just over 160 territories and countries that are taking in these games.
Some of them execute the productions on their own. They take the world feed and they might add an announcer.
Just like if they were in the arena in a broadcast truck, they're able to then produce their telecast. We have a line cut from our production team here that they're using to guide their call. And it'll make it look like they're in the building.
I'm producing a game based solely on what's happening on the ice. You know, normally you're following the announcers to help tell their stories the best you can. We don't have that here with all the regional sports networks and the national broadcasters. It's paramount that I tell them what's coming next so that they can relay it to their talent in order to give them a heads up as to what's coming.
As a world feed, you have to be fair, you have to be balanced for both sides. For any broadcaster around the world that wants to take it, also along with that, you have to provide as much information so they can help their broadcast know what's coming next.
So it's gonna be quite the marathon here over the next couple months.
And it's gonna evolve. You know, we're gonna learn as it goes. We have all these different camera angles that our world feed production team can integrate into the show and provide all our regionals and national broadcasters with some very unique content to tell stories.
I equate putting this host world feed production together to like building a car. The biggest challenge though is you've got 25 different parties that have their own ideas of what they'd like to have. So you collaborate, you cooperate, you listen to everybody and you figure out what's going to make this thing work. and hopefully that car starts and it runs well and it sounds good. And then when you put it out on the highway, you get nothing but thank yous. It's a great ride.